as you grow in your culinary career, you will be defined by how well you handle your knife. When chefs interview chefs for jobs, we look at not only how you cook, but you know, your knife skills. Knife skills tells a chef a lot about the person.
To go along with what Chef Saka was saying, both of us are very animate to make sure the students' knives are very extremely sharp. It reflects on when they're cutting their proteins or the vegetables or whatever, the knives have to be extremely sharp so that we have the proficiency and the proper results.
Today we're here at AI, the Art Institute in Santa Monica. Today's theme we're going to be working with is stealing a knife, actually maintaining an edge, and a rolled edge. What you got for me?
I've got a Santoku knife that needs to be sharpened, sir.
Okay. As you can see, it's got a fluted edge on both sides. So what we're going to do is we're going to put a flat ground edge on the bottom of the knife with a leather finish. We're going to use this, the stainless deburring wheel, to smooth it out for you. Now we're going to hit it on the leather wheel to give a nice, smooth finish.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Would you like a catalog?
Yes, please.
Now we're up to the fun part, I think, while you're all here. A rolled edge. Do you understand what I'm saying when it's rolled? It's not standing straight up, it's literally rolled to this side, okay? In my opinion, what happens with an edge that just goes bad, really bad, is because it had rolled and you didn't catch it quick enough. Okay, now what's the first signs that a knife is rolled? Drag, one would assume, right? Drag, you could just feel that it's dragging depending on what you're cutting. Now, when you have a rolled knife, you need to figure out what side it's rolled to and then start on that side. Now, again, everybody does it differently. I'm just gonna show you the easiest way to do it. It's just to take it like this from the heel. Did you hear it? How smooth that was and how light that was? Now, to get that straightened up, we're just gonna go a nice smooth lick on the side that's rolled, and then you check it again. Now, everybody here has their own way of stealing, okay? The way I steal is by sound, believe it or not. When I teach classes, I like to teach it like this. Can you hear that? Sound smooth? Cut. We're on the same page? So light, such a light touch. Light touch and accuracy is what's going to keep you an edge. The object is when you're done stealing, check it to see if it's rolled. I can't tell you how many of my customers come to me and say, well, my edge just didn't last. And I said, okay, here, steal it. And they go, I'm like, well, don't even talk to me, you know, until you learn how to maintain a product. Look at the edges as literally aluminum foil. Very thin piece of aluminum foil that's very, very fragile. We all understand the same thing, right? It's your fault your knife is dull, okay? It's not mine, it's yours. And the reason that it's dull is because you misused it or you overworked it with a steel. You run your finger from the back to the front, and then when you find out, oh, right here, it's tweaked. These two teeth are rolled this way, okay? You just take it flat, see how flat it is? Flat on the steel. And what that's going to do is it's going to make the teeth that are misaligned stand straight back up.
Before today, I knew the basic styles of knives, but until the demonstration, I didn't know the different types of edges for knives. Overall, it was great. I mean, it was quick, it was to the point. He makes it very comfortable, he was very fun and made it entertaining.
I love this guy, look at this. I wish I had on my glasses like that too.
The good thing about Capehart and Chris, you can tell he's really passionate about what he does.
So when you think about personality, when you think about his knowledge in the industry, the results that you get from him.
It's the real deal as far as I'm concerned.
So the goal is to be able to get the student with the right edge for the right job, with the right steel to maintain it, and have a mentality of how to work with it so that the knife will last longer, the edge will last longer, and their job will last longer.